That hand is here, this hand goes, this hand snaps, bam. As simple as that. We don't worry about him catching with an elbow, because that arm is a little jelly right about now. So as we come in, whole hand full. Come around, snap. He turns around to face me, guess what he has? Hammer. Okay? We know this hand, I'm gonna check it, so be careful. Boom, check that hand. We do it around, then we start chopping away. Everybody see that? That's the stop. That's the check. And we check. We don't worry about this hand. We done messed that one up. So again, very slow. Boom, boom. Snap. And you can play with that. Hit him right in the knot. Remember, you don't have a cup. Please express the sentiments to your partner. Because if I see you rolling around and you didn't say nothing, that's on you, buddy. It's the Kempo mentality. Who'd like to see that technique again? No? Look behind you. Double parry, boom, boom. This is a chopping hand. This is what messes you up. So you go here, hard as you can. Just grab a handful like you want to grab a basketball. Snap it. Snap it. Everything is right here. You can take a throw. You can take an arm bar. You can smack them in the pee-pee. Or as my little girls at home, they said, Professor said pee-pee. Okay. So we go again. One, two, boom, snap. Any questions? Go to work. Grab a partner.
Okay. So if you never want to see the arm back, you should be sorry. There's our. Grab a face.
I'm looking at it.
The worst, yeah, we're still at the first part. Go ahead. So it's.
Yeah, when you do it, you go over here and do it at double parrot. Face. You see how I bring it down? This one is right here.
Okay. See, it's okay.
Do you want to just do that?
If you do this.
Okay? We remember this one, huh?
You'll say, oops.
But again, Walter Godin taught us never to hit here. Because if you had a club or a stick or a bottle and you hit here, his hands open up. And what's he hitting? You're a big noggin, that's what he's hitting. But if you go deep, right? Deep, it picks him up. Then we go in. Down, you see, bladder, mace the spine. We catch him right in the face, mace the skull, hit him in the bladder, hit him in the spine. We catch him, and we just catch him here and do a takedown, and then you do all your little add-ins. So again, one, buddy, we go down. We go down this way, not this way, this way, like we're putting two daggers in it. And we slap him in the jaw. Catch his face and take him down. Okay? Anybody caught that? Who would like to see it again?
I would.
Holy mackerel! Walter would be proud. That's one of his.
And excuse me, guys. Could you guys kneel when he's showing so they can give you the camera?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay? And this comes, and Walter Godin's Roman wall was Sonny Gaston, so I'm sure he had a piece of that. Sonny Gaston was kind of example. When he broke away from Sonny, Sonny taught, how many of you guys used to watch the old Wild Wild West? Robert Conrad. Robert Conrad was the black belt of Sonny Gaston. And of course, Bill was up before they promoted him and corrupted him into Kaji Kempo. Okay, we'll go back. Okay, one, two, you see it? Three, three! Catch him in the face, take up a brick. And then shoot down. Walter never liked to go down on his knee because he's a big man. He just put up his foot and cockroach stomped you. Okay, we got some big cockroaches. Any questions? We'll do it slow. One, two, three, grab the whole face, and then your takedown. Go to work. As you see the women from white to orange here, pull in, chop, cut. That's about as easy as you can get. Come up, palm face him, whip it in. Look at it. Chop here, grab a thumb. You ready for this?
Boy, am I.
Grab a thumb. You see the thumb?
Oh!
Joint grab. Anybody ever heard of a joint grab? Just
no.
A little bum?
But how?
Yes. ask and you shall receive.
Okay, you see this hand? You bend it. This part you touch. And you touch here. Now, scream if you want to.
Okay, he's careful.
Ow! That's the way to go.
Yeah. Ah, there it goes. Yeah.
All right, Mike.
How much did he get? See? I didn't grab, I flexed.
And then you control. And that's only with this finger. That's all. Of course, you have to point to the other finger and point to the middle finger and try to restore. That's all it is, see? For women, I teach this. Grab it, turn it, all the way. I'm not going to do it for here it comes. But it goes underneath, and then I push this elbow, snap, and dislocate. Yeah, I can't punch you without it being hurt. Hey, Tyrone, where's your gi? If you don't come in here at least pay respect and hug me like a brother, you're in trouble. Come here, man. Go ahead, knock it out.
How you doing, Tara?
Good. What you doing?
Yeah, 3:30, 3:45, 3:30, 3:45. Yeah.
Okay, no. Both.
their turn, and I didn't end up. That's all. Play with it a little bit so you get the feeling of bonding. We're going to parry off, and we can't bring our hands up quickly to defend ourselves. Okay? But I'm going to hit them on the way up anyway. Okay, so the punch comes, go boom! What am I doing? And then I drive in. Then I drive in as hard as I can. Right above that knee. And I'm afraid of Charlie, that is unforgivable. So what I do, hit these two knuckles right here, I dive on, and I can use this, or I can turn to use this, doesn't matter. But from here, and then already I'm flexing on. When you see I touched it, that's already I'm flexing on. If he's a very bad boy and wants to really hurt me, once I flex, I climb. I climb right up his tree, force it, break it, kneel, and I don't even have to go down and fight. Okay, again, one, two, three, and if you like to leave a llama, here we go, leave a llama. And what am I going? Boom. I'm not even looking at his legs. What do I do? Boom. So we can do either or either. One, two, three. You see this hand? Okay? I'm going to do some terrible things later. I'll show you how to do terrible things. Okay, one. Oh, man. He could have hit, killed me. And go, oh, man. He could have killed me. Go to work.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah
I'm down and up. You know what that does? I'm cranking that arm. This point of this elbow jams into his bicep. Okay? Now you can do one or two things. You can move it away from here, or you can punch it away. Look what you got. You start hitting. Work all the way down. Again, this is the fourth one. One, two, snap, point. Okay? Move. Go to work. No, don't change hands. Give me your hand. Okay, everybody pay attention. Okay? Matt, where are you? Matt is warming up over there. Once that grab is made, I turn. I shoot. That's how it looks like. Once I catch that, I palm. I chop, chop, hammer, blow up that knee. And if I want, I scoop kick, and then I pick up Junior from school building. Okay? So everybody see that? Again, one. That neutralizes that fist because if you try to punch me, difficult. Two, chop. Three, chop. Right below the earlobe. Hammer. Pull off the knee. Turn if you want. Scoop and drag. Watch my whole body turn. And I'm still what? Watching. But I want to move. I put my head here and drop my knee on his face and I'm watching. Be paranoid in a fight. Look around. Look around. Look for an exit. It's not bad to be paranoid in a fight. I may hit you upside the head. I see what you do, my friend. I may hit you upside the head with an alley apple. Who knows what an alley apple is? A red brick I picked up and threw it at your head. I see what you did, my friend. I don't want no part of you. You're out there kung fuing and Bruce Lee on him. And I'm up, nah. Here's this beer bottle. That's why we teach our kids, we have little spongy balls. They do self-defense, we throw it right at their head. Boom. What was that for? I'm his friend, I saw what you did to him. So now they're paranoid. They're like, where's Professor? Where's Professor? That's what you pull off. Good idea. Why are you looking around? To escape. Door. Someplace to run away safely. See if you got a friend with a trash can cover. A brick. Be paranoid. You police, you know about that. Look around. Survey. Like an old Filipino joke we have. Filipino was up there. He said, why'd you hit him with the pool stick? Because it couldn't lift up the pool table. Okay? So you got to be always thinking of people out there. All right, you got to be one step ahead of them. You got to be paranoid. It's not. I repeat, it's not bad to be a little paranoid in a fight. I'll tell you that from get-go. If you haven't been in a fight, you'll never be paranoid. Perfect technique will always work because it's a perfect world, right?
No.
It's an imperfect world, so you better be prepared for that technique that he goes offline. And he said, what, wait, am I supposed to do this, and this, and this? Now he changed the game plan. You better be prepared for the game plan. So again, watch. Never do this. Now you're fighting. Here, keep it close. You see that? Again, one. Two, three. That would be right across the bridge of his nose with this. Right across the bridge. Once you shoot out blood, mucus, you go watery eye. Tengo mucho helado.
Agua en la boca, no quiero mirar nada, ¿sí? Ok, otra vez, mira. Ok, 1, 2, 3, 4. Watch my body to his web. Twist and turn. Then you can shoe job him if you want. How many people understood that technique? How many bother to see it again? Okay, come here. The grab is made. This is a no-no. This you turn in. You're here, you strip, you hit. Now he's strong, I still turn. Everybody got it?
Yes.
You want to pull up and snap that wrist, you come right in here. Desperation. You can shoot the fingers in the eyes. This guy, some weirdo, but a dragon advantage, pulling his tummy, bring him close, twist, and shoot the finger in the eye. Desperation moves. El ojos. The other one, break across the nose. The other one, hit him across the throat. This guy's got no neck, so I'm going to hit him across the bridge of the nose. Go to the outside, take him down. Any questions? That'll work. What I do is I, here, did everybody see that? Boom, boom, boom. Okay, I'm just here, finger slap, uppercut. Now watch this elbow. Boom, boom, boom. What I do? Now watch, this hand, wide open this hand. Catch a pow, pow, boom. All that should be standing here is the shoes. Okay, so I do a double pop on it, boom, eye. What did I do? Uppercut, turn the elbow, boom. Look at this, like a catcher bit. Slap, palm. This is like a high block, isn't it? High blocks are for this too. I will high block if I'm grappling with you and I wham! Catch you in a high block, I will catch you right underneath that chin. Okay? Like I said, shoes and socks should be here, he should be gone. Okay, so double chop, fingers here, turn, hand, pop here, go, catch, groin. Just have a good old this big bad child molester. Okay, go to work. 1, 2, 4, palm up. And then she brings her foot and then she puts an imprint in his face. The thing is to have the palm up and it's above the elbow and you snap down. That will cause hyperextension of the elbow. You don't do it here, right above the elbow. Do it again. And then she can, yep, there you go. Nice to have men at your feet, honey. But remember, if the top is the palm up, do it again. Boom. There you go. Now, cross, do it one more time, and I'll show you how to waste, not waste the kick. Go. Stay. Take that right foot and kick him in the jaw and go past his face. Not for real now. Go right past his face. And come back and catch him with your heel coming back. If you go forward, why not come backwards? You're wearing a shoe. You got a shoe where it's made of. Made in China. Okay, one more snap, snap. Catch a wife. Poof. Have I got your attention? Now, poof, poof. I now definitely have your attention. Got it? Concrete. You don't want to fight no more. You're going to pick up his toys and go home. Okay, that's all there is to it. Okay, what we're going to do is what we call a careful speed drill. Now everybody's going to have fun. You guys know it's hard. I'm coming back. I'm going to shoot a hammer. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Hit, drag. 1, 2, 3, 4. What did I do? What did I do? Same thing. Hammer, hammer, uppercut, scraping back knuckle. Elbow, palm, palm, height, drop. Everything I do is with a purpose. Once I hit, then I go about my business. So you can't do that? Yes, I can. I'll throw him up against the wall, work him. Every time he moves down, I'll knee him in the groin and sit him back up. But the wall is there, he won't fall. He won't fall back because they got a brace. And that's why I'm going to shoot him. I'm going to shoot him, I'm going to work him over. Man, you guys come on?
Yeah.
Once I do it, I'm going to run away. He said, this guy nearly killed me. I'm going to wham! Did you see that? He nearly killed me. When I turn, I put my hand out there so I can defend myself. Turn. So everybody do it slow. One, two, uppercut, drag, flexes, sandwich, palm, palm, here, down, run like hell.
Good.
Go for it.
Yeah, when you're out here like this, my elbow has flexed. Your elbow has flexed.
Hammers, the punch comes straight to the face, boom, I hit him right in the bladder, the top of the hammer. He wants to bend over, keep his guts. So when he bends over, I come up, hit him, hammer, hammer, hammer. Okay, carry off, hit him in his bladder, groin, up over, hammer, hammer. Okay, wind up the crank. I mean, you got Give you a little bit of temple history. Everybody knows, when you say Kempo, you are saying Champa. Okinawa says Kempo. That's their translation of Champa. Champa means pistol. Okay, we didn't say Champa. We said Kempo. We said the Okinawa say for Champa. When you say Tai Chi Chuan, friend also the piss. Chuan, piss. Champa. Chinapa, the reference, the season marks. But the man who brought it, Bitosi, called it Kempo. Translated over from Champa. Okay, now, if you have any questions about your history, now if you don't want to hear the truth, don't ask. Because I'll be brutally honest and I'll tell you the truth. I have paper, I have documentation, I have many, many things that show we have some very bad men in Kempo. You know, yours don't go back to Shaolin, no. Yours go to Hawaii. Your blood is in Hawaii. And your guy, actually, if Bitosi was the train track, Chow would be in Japan. He produced Ed Parker, Ralph Castro, Emperor. But he died to a disaster. So, if anybody wants me to ask questions about Kempo, me now. If not, you can stand up, bow, and you can take your sleigh dogs and go home. Is there any questions about your Kempo? Raise your hand. Yes, sir.
With Kempo and Kempo, the different translations.
K-E-M-P-O. If you say Ken, if your kanji ain't right, Kenjutsu, Kendo, the blade arm. Ken, K-E-N. Ken. K-E-N. Found the Champa. So the N is correct. That's what I was taught. By a scholar named Bing Fai Lao. He studied Kung Fu, Tai Chi, Kung Fu, and he was also black belt under Okazaki Sensei of Hawaii. Gansan ruler, Wang Jie. Any other questions? Yes, sir. Mitosi. And then he taught Chao, and then Bitosi got into a little trouble when he left that. You know, sometimes you got bad boys, they got bad things, but that doesn't take away from their art. Mine was Walter Godin. He's the one that knocked around Al Espresso. He smiled. Do you want to hear the story?
Yes.
Okay. Walter Godin lived across the street from the studio, Pasadena. He sees a pink Cadillac outside. What color was Elvis's favorite color? Pink. So Walter said, ooh, Elvis. So Joe gets his wrap, his hat on, takes his cap. Because tank top, he goes across the street. And Ed always talked to the local boys. Ed was from Hawaii. And he said, you're a homeboy, you train for free. So he's over there, boom, boom, just digging into the heavy bag. So, ring, and Parker, oh, telephone. He's talking, and he goes, Walter, my teacher, has brain dead as he is, he said, hey, Elvis, come here. Let me show you something. Swing on me. Pop, 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 boom, boom, swept him, boom. Ed turned around. Oh, thank you, Walter, thank you. Elvis Presley got up, staggered over to Walter. But he didn't make one complaint. From that day on, he had respect for Elvis. Because he didn't make one complaint. He took his beating. Tough Southern boy. Took his beating, didn't say one thing. And Walter had some heavy hands. Oh, God. Back in the day, he caught me with a front kick and picked my butt right off the floor. And in those days, that was back in the 70s when I weighed 190. Of course, I got a little bit more weight on me now. But that was Walter. Any other questions? Ask me now. Yes, ma'am.
What do you know about Imperado?
Imperado? Well, a lot. He trained with Chow, got promoted to Godan. He left. He got a bunch of, he trained with a guy. In Palama, he died, and then he brought in the Black Belt Society. Black belt society is nobody's business. We're going to create something. You judo. What happens if you face a boxer? You kempo. What happens if you face a jiu-jitsu man? You. What happens if a kempo man faces a karate man? And they had all these tricks. We used to call them tricks. Instead of, you know, self-defense or combos and stuff in modern terminology, it's called tricks. Trick one, trick two, trick three. And it was always against something else. Then they created katas. Then they created, then they opened up. You had to be 18 and over. You had to be a man. No kids. No women. Because the contact was bare knuckle and violent. And Brad was saying was, there's no blood on the floor. Passing over. So you can imagine what kind of class and brutal it was, all bare knuckle fighting. Marino Tivanac fought for the world championship of the world. And he was the first black belt produced out of Palama. Marino Tivanac. He created a CHA 3 Kempo when he left Emperado after Joe's death because he loved Joe. Goodness. Joe Emperado was the brother, younger brother of Adriano Ninoy. I know him personally. And they came together with Frank, Peter Chu. Peter Chu, they said, was a boxer. All right. And they said, Tatsuda. There was a Tatsuda at the time. Kind of exaggerated. Creative differences, you understand. Karate, brought in the karate man, judo man, jiu-jitsu man, kempo, the main driving force, and bull. At first it was boxing, American boxing. Then they changed it over to Chinese boxing, Chinese kung fu, because they didn't want to, the boxer was tired of all the nonsense going on in Kempo. Joe died, he was murdered. And then they changed over to kung fu, and that was Aldo Costas. How many people have heard of Aldo Costas? Yeah, Aldo Costas is a friend of mine, and his son is Mark DeCosta. He's seen all these movies, The Chef. That's
why. Iron Chef, yeah.
So, these, I'm getting a little, I know myself, but I know all these guys back home. If I don't know them, they're probably from the mainland or just got their grand master promotion from DT and they're hiding under rocks. I don't know. Any other questions? Yes, sir.
Back in the day before jiu-jitsu and grappling was mixed with chemicals.
There was jiu-jitsu in Hawaii because next time I come here, I will show you mixed martial arts from the 1920s. We had in Hawaii, boxer take on jiu-jitsu man. 1920s. That's a decade, maybe a decade and a half before the Gracies. 1920s. Motobu Sensei, the great Okinawan fighter, came in the 1920s to challenge a boxer. He came over and he said, why are you here? To fight. That didn't stand good with the... Guess what? Immigration. So they put them away. They put the next boat to Japan and sailed them back home. But there were guys that came, washed his clothes, bought him food, and he taught him his kempo because it was called Motobu Ru Kempo. And Udonde came later, and that was their family line. Udonde means palace hands. When you do this, you are doing Udonde. That's actually locks. What does this remind you of? Oh, I'll use that. This, thrusting eyes, blocking his eye. This, trapping, grabbing, ripping. It was the beginning of the secret art of the Palace of Okinawa, who protected the kings of Okinawa. This is the first beginning of Udonde, which means palace hands. That's where he got this from. So you even got Okinawa in your background because of that. Udonde. And I'm, well, first, the Udonde suffer the weapon and the damage. They don't actually do katas, they do flurries and spin and turn. Their Udonde is throws and locks and chokes. That's that. So every time you do this, you're doing a Udonde. Every time you do this, you're doing reverse motion. For every motion, forward motion, there's a back motion. Forward and back. Side. Side. Oh, no.
very active as a reactor. That's his role. Any other questions? Yes, ma'am.
How did you come up with your style?
Well, I've been around. Sounds like a Rolling Stones song.
I've been around for a long, long time.
No, I'm a 20-year man from the Army. I'm retired. I've been in Vietnam, Korea. I saw arts. I saw arts where Filipinos would take blades and they go into, they put the antikapin and they actually stab themselves and they go into a trance and they leave no blood. And I seen the way they do their stick and blade art. I did their blade art also. I go to Korea, learn some of their kicking, not no more, not with these old ladies. I've been to Japan, I've been to many places where they have their arts. I took these arts. A lot of people said, you can't do that. I said, why? You did. And Frank Ordonez said, looked at my jiu-jitsu. He recommends people to be with jiu-jitsu. Frank was one of the creators of Kaji Kempo also. Frank promoted me the ninth. So, whether they like me or not, I don't care. It's Frank the one when he creates it. He's the last one left. All the creators. Kaji Kempo. Any other questions? Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell me how much Ed Parker Sr. I've heard you had changed some?
Ed Parker Sr. took the self-defense, and for whatever it's worth, a guy in Arizona, USAA, Tria says, why don't you do kata? Because you have no kata, you're doing with chow. That was only self-defense within the dam. Tria said, great. He got with a kung fu guy, Wu. He borrowed a lot of his techniques with his self-defense and the Chinese style. He mixed it. And he formulated his katas. Then you need a kata for belt and so many self-defense moves. Answer your question?
Sort of, okay.
Any other questions? Kempo Jitsu, when I say Kempo, and I say Jitsu, it's Jiu-Jitsu means techniques. Like you say Jiu-Jitsu, soft techniques. So I say Kempo. The art of Kempo is punching, kicking, grappling. It's a Jiu-Jitsu. And Kempo Jitsu merely means the techniques of Kempo. That's all it means. Any other questions? None? Please stand. I enjoyed. Oh, by the way, if you want any video or t-shirts, my wife is back there. If you enjoy it, see her. The t-shirts, when you say Kura Urukupali, that was Walter Godin's School of Self-Defense in Hawaii. When you look at Chuck Liddell, teacher, Hackelman, he has Kula Pon Kupali, and he has Daruma. That was from Walter Godin. So Chuck Liddell is in your bloodline, because Hackelman taught Chuck, Walter Godin taught Hackelman. Okay, and these are the Hawaiian t-shirt over there, that's from the Hawaiian Warrior, and the other is the t-shirt, we got videos. See, my wife says you gotta get paid. And she put me on allowance because that's all I'm allowed to have. So I wish to thank my sponsors and my Massachusetts rep. Thank you very much. And I'm so honored to share with you my techniques. Thank you very much.